for all you freshers out there, there's a new and exciting job opening for you. If you have an affinity for throwing tantrums, sorry, rocks, send in your resumes and we'll consider you for the job. You're part of a rock band, you say?
Yes.
Who are your influencers?
I couldn't tell you that.
Perfect. A loyalist. So tell me, what size rocks do you prefer?
I like big ones, the ones that weigh about 333 grams. However, the 256 gram hand rock flat stone is my favorite.
Certainly knows his stones. Wait a minute. It says here you have kidney stones. You're wired. According to media reports, there exists a group of insidious villains called stone pelters in Jammu and Kashmir. For a stipend, these villains are funded by underground masters to carry out deadly attacks on security forces and vehicles during times of unrest.
This is a story that's already going viral, and over the next 1 hour, we will get reactions from Kashmir, we'll get reactions from the rest of the country. Remember, this is something that's been spoken of for a very long while.
Now hold on, I really don't sympathize with stone pelters, but painting them as villains? Surely you aren't taking any side now, are you? Villains. Now who ailed you as terminology expert? If there wasn't enough happening already, that you had to add more dramatic effects. I guess it wasn't graphic enough. It's not that I don't agree with you, but really, do you want to incite more passions with your effects? Anyway, the matter at hand, the stone pelters' remuneration. For weekdays, the pay is around 700, and on holy Fridays, the stipend increases to rupees 1000 per day. Oh, and if you're a young boy with good physique, your monthly salary will be somewhere around 7000 to 7500. For children up to 12 years, the minimum payment for stone pelting is fixed to rupees 4000. Talk about unemployment in India? These are not jokes, these are facts. This goes on to show India that even if you don't provide adequate employment opportunities, someone or the other will create one. When there are no lucrative legal ways out of these, people will look for illegal options. And come on, 1000 per day to throw stones? That's good money. Let's face it. On second thought, let's not. In a joint effort, reports said that nearly 300 WhatsApp groups were being used to mobilize the stone pelters in Kashmir, of which 90% have been shut down. The police said that they have identified the admins of these groups and they are being called in for counseling. So you've been pelting stones. How does it make you feel?
Should I try to hide the way I feel inside?
India Today conducted a sting operation where they allegedly exposed a few stone pelters. The men are seen on video chatting without any hesitation in length about their jobs, payroll, about their methods and procedures. Now this goes on to show that there are mixed with people who are actually fighting for freedom, these mafia groups, which are funded by extremist groups. But this is not new information to us. We can all assume that for any movement that happens, there are people who take advantage. But let's not get muddled up in all of this. It does not take away the demand for security, the demand for freedom, and the dilemma that is Kashmir. And desperate times call for desperate measures. So I get it that the people of Kashmir are fighting back with stones because they don't have weapons. And believe me, I'm glad they don't, but I'm pretty sure they do. And stones are a mask to infiltrate the groups of people who are genuinely affected by this. But violence is not the answer. This doesn't mean I'm not sympathizing with the people of Kashmir. I can't even begin to fathom their struggles. Sticks and stones will break your bones, but will never do any good to anyone. In fact, it creates more enemies from within. The actual price for being the best pelter will most likely be a catapult. The message that needs to be sent to the people is that in all of this fighting against the powers that be, you are being used. And this sort of appraisal will not show you results. So let's stop this now and let's pick up our stones and throw them away. Oh no, we are all professional stone pelters now. Well, at least I'm employed.
I got a job.
At the end of the day, it's not WhatsApp's fault, it's not your fault, and it's definitely not my fault. But are you telling me that 300 WhatsApp groups with 250 people each, meaning 75,000 people, kept it all a secret? Are you telling me that a news agency could go undercover and expose them, but the army or the intelligence agencies couldn't gather enough intel? But hey, what do I know? Let's just say, in this day and age, information is just a stone's throw away.